Hey, what's going on? Jeff Ratcliffe here. It's fantasy football draft season, and we've all been there before on fantasy draft day. We make a mistake. Nothing worse. It haunts you the whole draft. May haunt you the whole season, in fact. So here are five mistakes to avoid making on draft day this year in 2018. The first, not doing your prep. If you don't do your prep, if you aren't prepared, you're not going to draft well. Don't be that guy. We all know that guy. We have that guy or that gal in our league every year. They don't do their prep. They're driving to the draft. They stop at a convenience store, or a bookstore, or a drugstore. They pick up the first fantasy magazine they see, and that's what they use, right? And that thing was written in April. You know, they miss out on all of the player movement, on all of the injuries, on all of the trends, and their teams typically stink. So do your prep work. And of course, we can help you with the prep work over at Pro Football Focus. We have all of that laid out for you. Do your prep. Number two, on draft day, don't go on tilt. Going on tilt, what does that mean? It's a poker term. We know if you have a mistake, you internally start to stoop. We've been there, right? You're sitting there, you have your guy lined up. He's who you want to pick, and he gets picked right before you, right? Happens to the best of us. It always happens, right? So what happens? You're scrambling, you're flipping through papers, you're trying to figure out a guy, and then you just run up to the board, see the first name there, put the sticker on the board, right? Okay, fine, you made the pick. Nobody even noticed. You sit down, and you realize there was somebody else there who you probably should have taken instead, right? Now, you're cool, maybe have a sip of your beverage, but you're stewing inside. And what happens there? You made a mistake. Now, that mistake isn't just gonna simply go away. It's gonna stick in the back of your mind, and you may make more mistakes as a result. It has a compounding factor to it. That's not a good thing. So avoid going on tilt. How do you do that, though? Build a draft board. It's pretty simple. And I actually have some tips on that on another video here on the channel. But build yourself a draft board. That's part of prep, by the way. Build yourself a draft board and then stick to your draft board. Your draft board, you're not going to get sniped. If that player gets picked right before your pick, you're going to have other guys who you can possibly go with as well. So build that draft board to avoid going on tilt. Next, don't lock yourself in positions. And what does that mean, locking yourself into a position? It means this. I can't tell you how many people I've heard say this. Well, in the first round, I'm going to draft a wide receiver. Then in the second round, a running back. And in the third round, I'm going to draft a wide receiver. Okay, that's fine. But what if your draft board says the better value is at running back in the first round? Or vice versa, at every single one of those spots. So instead of just following the draft board, drafting for value, getting the best players, what you're doing is you're doing a little square peg in a round hole. You're trying to force, because you want to take that wide receiver in the first round, you're trying to force it. So you take a guy who isn't the best value. You know what you just did, by the way? You gave your opponents an advantage. You just let value slip to them. Just on a sill, here you go. Would you like some value? You're giving it to them. So I don't want to do that. I treat draft day like it's a game as well. It's not just the weekly games that we play. It's everything in fantasy. It's all a game. And you want to win every single one of those games, including draft day. So you don't want to lock yourself into any positions. You want to figure out, especially in the early rounds of your draft, you want to figure out where the value is and get those players at value. Do not let value slip to your opponents. How many times have you come out of draft day, you look at one of your opponent's rosters and you go, how the heck did he do that? How did he get all of those players? That's how. Everybody else in the league let value slip, and that opponent of yours was smart enough to capitalize on that. Don't let them do that. Don't let them do that. Number four for us, using only one strategy. So going into a draft, essentially, you want an arsenal of strategies. You want to be as flexible as possible, not just one strategy. You know, I'm going to be zero RB. I'm going to be late round quarterback, whatever it is. You want to have a multitude of strategies at your disposal so that in the draft, based on the conditions, you're able to adjust and you're able to make your opponents pay. So if you want help on different draft strategies and how you can use all of them together in conjunction, we do have a draft strategy video series here on the channel all of the different positions. I break down different strategies for you. You can use all of those. You may not use all of them in one draft, but over draft season, if you're in multiple leagues, you're probably going to dip into each one of them at various points. So only one strategy, not an ideal. Finally, the number five mistake that you need to avoid to dominate your fantasy draft, that is drafting quarterbacks too early. You don't need Aaron Rodgers to win your fantasy league. I said it, you don't need Aaron Rodgers to win your fantasy league. And I know in home leagues, it's different than fantasy industry leagues. People draft quarterbacks earlier. They do, that's fine. But you know what? You don't need to win your league. You can get guys in the 8th, 9th, 10th round and be just fine, especially if you're in 10-team leagues. But even in 12-team leagues, there's so much value at the quarterback position. Don't draft quarterbacks too early. Let the value fall, and you will be successful this year. So there you have it. Do your prep. Don't go on tilt. Don't lock yourself into positions. Don't use just one strategy, and don't draft a quarterback too early. What are some of the mistakes you've made or you try to avoid on draft day? Give us a comment below. Of course, subscribe to the channel for more fantasy videos coming up soon. And go to profootballfocus.com for all of your fantasy football needs. That's profootballfocus.com.